After almost a decade of serving as Quezon City Vice Mayor, Joy Belmonte is now ready to follow the footsteps of her father, former mayor-turned-congressman Sonny Belmonte. On October 11, she will file her certificate of candidacy for the mayoralty. Belmonte is confident the polls will favor her, especially since she is only being hounded by one issue.
That I cannot suspend classes, things like that, no? Because there was a time that there was a habagat, and I relied on the PAGASA report, and it turns out the PAGASA report missed out on some other aspect, and I acknowledge that there was that mistake.
Among her priorities is maintaining a clean system in the city hall. Meanwhile, 1st District Representative Bingbong Crisologo says he is ready to face Belmonte in the 2019 elections. While he hasn't thought of an exact date, Crisologo says he will file his COC within the given period. When asked what separates him from his opponent, he only had one answer: his years of experience in public service.
Totoo, I was imprisoned for 8 years. Nung nakulong ako, naranasan ko ang buhay ng mahirap. Now I can use that experience. Alam ko ang damdamin ng mahirap.
Crisologo will be running alongside 2nd District Representative Winnie Castello, who is eyeing the vice mayor post. Among Castello's programs include fighting corruption, free Wi-Fi, and transforming the city into one that is world-class. This even if a lot of residents still live in poverty.
Hindi po pwede social services at the expense of infrastructure. They could coexist. We would be able to provide them employment.
Castello will be going against Giancarlo Soto, the son of Senate President Vicente Soto III, and currently a councillor in the city's 3rd district. ABS-CBN News tried getting a statement from Soto, but his staff say his schedule does not permit. A lot of other names continue to pop up as the filing of COC nears. They say they would rather reserve their statements for that day. Those running for top positions in Quezon City in 2019 are not new in politics. As a matter of fact, all of them currently hold positions. The only question now is whose plans and programs will be given a chance by the residents of Quezon City to be realized. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.